Now what we're going to do is start integrating more of what we've done throughout all of 30 Days of Python into this Hungry program. And we're going to do this by adding in new Python modules and then also adding in templates for text and HTML, you know, basically bringing all this stuff together. So what we're doing in this one in particular, we are going to make a new Python module called utils. And in that Python module, we're going to add another Python module called templates. And that's what we'll do our template-like functions. So if I actually open up the Finder window into my folder for Hungry, I have this old source here. And of course, if you don't have it and you deleted it, you can definitely check out GitHub for all of this stuff. So basically what I want to do here is bring over the templates and templates.py, right? So I want to have those two things working inside of my template or my main Hungry Python module. So to do this, I'm gonna make a new folder in here called utils, and I'm gonna go ahead and drag and copy. So with command and dragging, a copy and paste works as well. I'm gonna bring over that init file to make utils a function itself, and then I'm just gonna go ahead and copy that and change that into being templates. So I now have that utilities module with the templates module inside of it. So let's go ahead and open up that templates module as well as our old one. Let's go ahead and open up that as well. I'm gonna go ahead and copy from the old one into the new one. Notice you'll see it says utils and old source. Close out that old one, and now we have our new one. So there's a few things about it that are good. One of them that is not good is this git working directory. We do not actually want that. And then also the tests. These tests we don't actually, we're not gonna need once we put this in. But what I can do is cut that out and bring it into main, and we'll put it in with our messages stuff. Because basically this argument of message, if we have a message coming through, we're gonna wanna render that message and do some stuff with it. Meaning if we're gonna send them an email, we're gonna wanna render the context for that particular user at some point and then actually send that email. So the basic stuff we're gonna do is actually just running those sort of things here. All right, so now let's go back into our templates, and we wanna change our template path slightly, so it's more relevant to where this file actually is. So it's gonna be very similar to what we did in our other folder, or excuse me, into the data manager when we added this file item path. It's gonna be very similar to that, but instead we are gonna be getting a path passed into it, and we wanna get that path relative to the root of our project. So if we look at this, the root of our project is in here. Right, so this is the root of where it's going to be and where we want it to actually function. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm just going to just come in here, and we're going to use this same sort of function, and I'm going to paste it in here. And then instead of data.csv, I'm just going to paste in path. So that should actually update everything for us as far as the functions are concerned. I'm going to go ahead and save that. And going back into main, I want to actually import the templates. So I'll go from utils, import the git template function. All right, so we've got the git template function. That's all I'm gonna do for now. And we have the functions that we have, and then actually we'll also import our render context. So those are two things that we should do. We didn't change a whole lot. We just added a few things, and now we should be able to actually see the message stuff itself. So let's go ahead and try it out. I'm gonna open up fresh new terminal windows here, and I'm gonna change into the desktop, and I'll do Python Hungry, press enter. We get an error with this importing of git template. So let's go back into our templates. It should make sense because we did from utils, not from utils.templates. Now it should actually work. Let's try that again. And now the import does work. And if I add message, it gives us, this is not a valid template path. Notice the template path that it's giving us, it's saying utils templates email message, right? So if I wanted it in the root of the Hungry Python module, I would just add one more of these on top of that file, paste that in, run it again, and now we've got that new template path. That's where we want it. So inside of here, I'm gonna make another new folder and call it templates. And from our old source, we are gonna copy those original templates in here. All right, run it again. And now it's working. Cool. So that's actually giving us where it needs to be. And when we say file path, of course, that's related to the file template path, and that's what that function's all about. And now main is actually doing it as it needs to, right? It's finding those templates, it's rendering the context just as we've done before, but now we have this template module. So that means in our data manager, we can actually do all sorts of stuff in here as well. But inside of this data manager, I actually am gonna change the name of data manager to instead being data class.py. I'm gonna keep data manager as a file, but data class is really where we're gonna be working from here on out. So data class and data manager. Eventually I'll be moving data manager into old source, but data class is gonna be turning our data manager into a class, much like what we did already in our other, in one of the days that we worked on the classes itself. We actually have this hungry data, or sorry, not hungry data, but the message user class. So we're gonna actually be going after something a lot closer to this than what we have here. So let's go ahead and open up that messages user class, and we'll use this for inspiration. We're not gonna copy and paste yet, but we will bring over the data manager stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy everything in the data manager and bring it into this new file of data class. And now I'm gonna say class, and I'll say user manager. That's all I'm calling it. You could call it user manager. If you like, you don't have to call it user manager. It's really kind of up to you. And it's gonna be our class. So we're just gonna be converting our class into being able to read this data. I'm just gonna tab in here and go ahead and just add in self. And there we go. So now we have our user manager. This is the class that will actually update our read data or allow us to read our data. And instead of read data, I'm gonna just say get user data. That makes a lot more sense. So user manager, get user data. So this will allow us to call that stuff instead. So now back into our main file, we are gonna import the same sort of thing, but now instead of from data manager, we're gonna go ahead and tab that out and we'll do from data class. We're gonna import that user manager, right? So user manager. There we go. And then now down here with the read data, we'll do user manager dot get underscore user data, and just basically be changing just ever so slightly what it is that we're trying to do. So data class, user data manager, didn't really change a whole lot. Again, the reason we're doing it this way is step by step. So it's like kind of integrating into one flowing functioning application. Okay, so let's try that again. And then now instead of message, we'll say view and then ID of one. I press enter, of course it's still working. So I can go ahead and get rid of that original import. And now we're seeing this kind of formulate a little bit better. But of course we can go one step further and move all of this stuff into our data class as well, as we should. So we're gonna copy that same import here. I'm gonna copy this, bring it into data class, paste it in here, and then I'm gonna go ahead and copy all of this stuff, hit exit. Well, we'll leave the print statement for now and bring back into data class. And now I'll just say def message user. We'll worry about exactly how it works later, but for now I'm gonna go ahead and just say self. And there we go. So we've got our message user here, and I'll just return none. So now we have this message user function. We have the get template and the render context stuff. So let's go ahead and see if that works. I'm gonna go back into our templates here, or excuse me, our main file here. And instead of get user data, we're going to print out message user. So we're just gonna run that function of message user. We don't need to pass anything quite yet. And let's go ahead and run it and just message, press enter. And of course, there we go. We've got our messages now. So now this itself is a lot cleaner, as it should be, right? So it should absolutely be 100% cleaner than what we have here. And then of course, in our get user details in our data class, we can actually pass the user ID and email. So we don't need those two things in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that. Pass the both of those things. And get rid of the last print statement. Save that, press up, we got our message and we got our view. And then if I say email equals to, or I think we said e and hello at teamcfe.com. And there we go. So email also works. Okay, great. So this stuff is really starting to come together. Now what we need to think about is reading the user data and then converting that red data into context that actually makes sense. Right now that context does not make sense. It's just going off of one standard sort of thing. So that's what we'll have to do in the next one. If you have any questions on what we've done so far, let us know. Otherwise, we'll see you tomorrow.